I'm Andrew Edwards, and you're watching Gear Live. Despite everything that's been going on here in 2020, Samsung has been dropping impressive phones pretty much all year. From the Galaxy S20 and S20 Ultra to the Note 20 and Note 20 Ultra to the Z Flip and Z Fold 2 with foldable displays. And yet the company wasn't finished because up next is the Galaxy S20 Fan Edition. In this video, I give you a breakdown of the Galaxy S20 FE and why it matters. What's going on, Tech Squad? Andrew Edwards here. And as I mentioned in this video, I'm giving you a look at this guy right here. This is the Samsung Galaxy S20 Fan Edition. Now, as I said a moment ago, Samsung already makes the Galaxy S20, S20 Plus, and S20 Ultra among their other lines of mobile devices. So the question here becomes, what's different and why does this exist? So let's talk about the top five features of the S20 Fan Edition, starting with the design. It can't be denied that these days phones are almost as much a fashion statement as they are a communication tool. With the Fan Edition, Samsung made sure to recognize this fact with an array of colors, and they're marketing them heavily. You'll find the S20 FE available in lavender, mint, red, white, navy, which is the color Samsung sent over to me, and an orange color, which is what I wish Samsung sent over to me, but I digress. Now, rather than glass, the S20 FE has a plastic backing, but it doesn't feel cheap at all. All the colors also have a matte finish, which does pretty well at masking fingerprints. It's not perfect, but it does its job. Now, next up, let's talk about this display. The Samsung Galaxy S20 FE sports a 6.5 inch full HD OLED display, which puts it right between the Galaxy S20 and S20 Plus as far as size. The FE also sports a 120 hertz refresh rate, providing smoother graphics, animations, and transitions. But unlike the regular S20, it has a flat display rather than the curved edges, and you can't bump it up to quad HD plus resolution. Now, I personally don't find the resolution to be that big of a deal, and I find the flat display to actually be an improvement. Now, up next, it's an important part of any smartphone. Let's talk about the camera. The Galaxy S20 FE sports a triple camera system on back, including a main 12 megapixel camera with optical image stabilization, a 12 megapixel ultra wide camera, and an 8 megapixel telephoto lens, which supports 3x optical zoom along with a software based space zoom. And you do also get Samsung's great looking night mode here as well. On the front, you get a 32 megapixel selfie camera, which is great for both stills and videos. Another important piece of a smartphone is how long it lasts. So let's talk about battery life. With the Galaxy S20 Fan Edition, Samsung has packed in a 4,500 milliamp hour battery. So with the Galaxy S20 FE, 4,500 milliamp hours equates to pretty much all day battery life, thanks to both the size of the battery itself, the resolution of the display, and the AI intelligence built into the device that allows it to save power. Now, this phone also supports super fast charging, allowing you to get 50% charge in 30 minutes using a 25 watt charger. And it also supports fast wireless charging 2.0 as well. Now, lastly, we've got to talk about price. And this may be the biggest reason why the Galaxy S20 Fan Edition exists. The Samsung Galaxy S20 Fan Edition is available on October 2nd for $699, which is $300 less than the starting price of the standard Galaxy S20 lineup, although you can definitely find those on sale for less these days. It should also be noted that this phone does support 5G, which typically has resulted in higher prices, so it's nice to see a 5G Galaxy S device from Samsung that hits right at the $700 mark. Samsung created the FE in response to the global craziness that we're going through, wanting to release a phone that hit a lot of the main features that matter to the average consumer at a price that was more palatable during times like these. So we get a lower price point on a phone that is still premium enough to warrant being a part of the Galaxy S lineup and Galaxy S brand, or at least that's my opinion. What are your thoughts on the Samsung Galaxy S20 Fan Edition? Are you picking one up? Let me know down in the comments below and I'll meet you there for further discussion. I'm definitely feeling what a lot of the smartphone companies have been doing, pulling back a little bit from that $1,000 starting price and still making phones that are great and that are quality, but selling them for about 30% less. Now, we'll be talking even more about the Galaxy S20 FE on the next episode of Geared Up. Geared Up is the weekly podcast I do each week with John Rettinger, where we talk about the latest in tech, gadgets, and games. Just search for Geared Up in your favorite podcast player if you want to check it out. Thank you so much for watching. As always, guys, I appreciate your support. I'm Andrew Edwards, and I will catch you in the next video.